Share data using implicit intent. So currently we are in section 2 and we are about to explore our last video of this section. In this video we will check out how to share data to some other applications like WhatsApp, Facebook, Gmail, etc. That is to social media applications. Now in the previous video we checked out what is intent. That is, intent is an operation to be performed and it is of two types, explicit and also implicit. So in this video we are going to check out what is implicit intent. And in case of implicit intent, we don't know our target activity. So first of all, to avoid confusion, let us visually check out how does explicit intent works. Now suppose we are within the main activity where we have two fields of username and password and also a button. Now as soon as the user enters the username and the password and click on the submit button, then we navigate to our second activity with the help of intent. In this case, since we are aware that we are going to second activity, so in this case, this intent can be called as explicit intent. As simple as that. Now, suppose we want to pass on this username using the intent to the second activity and display here welcome SmartHerd. So what is the mechanism to do that? So for that, we have to pass in the username of SmartHerd using the key value pair, that is key as name and the value as SmartHerd, and then retrieve it and display it here like we did in the previous video. Remember? Now this was all about the explicit intent. So now let us come to our implicit intent. For that, let us take an example. Suppose we are within our main activity and we want to share this image to some other applications like WhatsApp or Facebook. So for that, the user will click on the share button. Now as soon as he clicks on the share button, his Android application is simply going to show this dialog box. That is, hey user, please select any application where you want to share this image. Now here the user might select the Gmail, Facebook, WhatsApp, Save to Drive, or even share to Hangouts application. Now in this case, the activity is being selected by the user in the runtime. So we are not sure where we are going to share our image because it is being selected by the user. So in this case, our intent will be known as the implicit intent. So in case of implicit intent, we usually share our data across different application activities. It might be anything. So I hope now you know what is the difference between explicit and implicit intent. Section 2, Video 5. And now within our activity main.xml, go to the design tab and here let us drag and drop another button right here, just below this button. And now let us modify the properties of this button. Simply select it and you can even modify the properties of this button by using this layout designer. So simply hold this handle and then stretch it like this, and even you can select the button and modify its attribute from the right hand side, such as change the layout width to match parent. Perfect. And now let us change the text of this button, for example share to other apps. Great. Also, let us modify the ID of this button, such as button share to other apps, and click somewhere else. Now go to the text tab and verify if everything is fine here. Yes, the ID is button share to other apps, text is this. Now let us use this button within our main activity and apply the onClickListener to it. Use the lambda expression and also define your intent. Now as a parameter, we don't have to pass anything because we are not sure to which activity we are about to share the data. So let us define the properties of this intent. Use intent.setAction. Let us use again the property of action equal to intent.actionSend. And now since we want to share this message that user will enter in this edit text, so let us copy this statement and paste it within the lambda expression. Perfect. Use intent dot put extra and give the key as the predefined key, such as intent.extraText. These are the few predefined key that are known to other applications like WhatsApp or Facebook. So we don't have to worry about it. How other application will know this key? These are the predefined key known to other application. And as a value, simply pass message. And also define the type of this message. So for that, we have intent.type equal to text plain. Perfect. And finally, we can start the activity and pass in the first parameter as intent.createChooser. Now, why I am using this method, I will let you know shortly. And then pass in the first parameter as intent and the second parameter as the dialog of the chooser. For example, share to which applications? Perfect. And finally, let us launch our application and let's see what happens. Here we go. Our application is now up and running. Let us enter the message. Hey, this is cat. And now click on share to other application. And there we go. We have got all of these options. Gmail, message, save to drive. Now, since I don't have WhatsApp or Facebook within my emulator, so it is just showing the Gmail application. Now, in case if your emulator don't show this Gmail, then what you can do is simply go to Google and then download Gmail app like this. Perfect. You can simply download the Gmail application in your emulator. It will work fine. Now let us move back to our application and let us complete our demo. Share to other application. Click on this Gmail. Well, I have to sign in here because this is the first time I am using the Gmail application in my emulator. Now that I have logged into my Gmail application, let us now go back to our application and click on this share button. Select Gmail. And there we go. Hey, this is cat. It is now working perfectly fine. We can now share this message to some other user by entering the email address here. Perfect. And one more thing at the end I would like to show you is that now if you open the application and click on this button, then you will get this dialog box. Well, it is basically the application chooser, which has the title on the top as share to. Now this share to dialog is coming from here, from the title which we have provided it here. Now you can change it to please select app, any user friendly message. Run the application again. And here, let us click on this button. And there we go, please select application. Our title has been changed. Perfect. So this was all about this video. So with this, we have reached the end of this section. So let us summarize our section 2. In this section, we first checked out what is an activity, what is a view, and how to design layouts by using views within our Android Studio. And next, we checked out what are intents and its types, such as explicit intent and also the implicit intent. And we checked out how to share data between activities using explicit intent, along with how to share data to WhatsApp, Facebook, and Gmail-like application using implicit intent. And along with these topics, we checked out two small topics of how to display a toast message to the user and how to use logcat to track the issue and rectify it, and also how to log out the values using the logcat. So this was all about this section. Congratulations. Now in the next section, we are about to see how to implement list and also how to use various Kotlin classes within our application. So thank you for watching and see you all in the next section. Bye-bye.